super cali fragilistic expialidocious.
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove to be a rather useful one. When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it...
Okay, this is Mary Poppins' magical carpet bag. As you can see, it looks like a pretty standard carpet bag on both sides, and it does have a bottom, which you could show to the audience, and from the audience it would look like a normal bottom. However, from the inside, that bottom is a false bottom that's been made to be able to lift up so that lifting up, it now is a false bottom that you can see through. There is a magnet in place right there that holds the bottom up when Mary has it up, and she can now lift props through it. Now for our production, the carpet bag was designed to sit on top of this dresser, which is just a simple dresser that you might find at a thrift store or anything, but it's been modified so that these drawers don't actually pull out. The back has been removed and it was mounted to a wall of the set. So Mary could set the bag down, take out her first prop, then lift up the false bottom. And at the same time, a stage crew member from behind the set could unlatch this trap door from back here, which would drop it down and allow props to be passed up from behind the set, through the dresser, and through the bag, and it would look like long items were being passed up through the bag. Okay, this is Mary Poppins' umbrella. It's been hand-painted. This is a composite material made in the 3D printer and overlaid over an existing umbrella, just a standard black expanding umbrella, and so she can handle this, do whatever she likes with it. She can roll it up, and when she's ready, spring load, push the button, and she has an umbrella. Okay, here we have a kite for the Let's Go Fly a Kite scene in the park with Bert. As you can see, it's a simple light fabric material with a tail on the end that is designed to attach in the center to this flexible pole, painted white to pass from the stage as a rope, but able to be mounted and controlled by the actors on stage so that they can manipulate the kites to look like they are floating and flying through the air, like so. This is designed to be a Starlighter's light pole. All it is a piece of PVC pipe that has been painted black with a light mounted to the end and a hand-controlled switch so that the people playing the Starlighters can light the light, go on stage, and use these as props to dance with. These are LED battery-powered lights in the end. Batteries are easily changeable with these popping off the ends as needed. And we have 8 of these. Okay, here we have a faux set of fire logs that is designed to look like they've been burning in a fireplace for a while. On our set, this would have been mounted inside of a fireplace facade, and mounted behind it, we have this simple device purchased from Amazon that when plugged in, lights up and gives the impression of fire. There's a little bit of a fan noise, but from the stage, it's not audible for the audience. And this was used to magically show the disappearance of the note that Mr. Banks ripped up and threw into the fireplace that Mary then magically showed up with a few seconds later in the same scene. And the disadvantage here is this is not currently battery powered. It does need to be plugged in. We were able to run the cord through the back of our set and have a stage crew member plug it in backstage due to the nature of our stage design. Okay, now we're going to demonstrate the spoonful of sugar collapsing table that magically repairs itself. As you can see, we've got just a regular table here. And this could easily have a tablecloth thrown over it, as would have happened in our production. And it would have been set in place by the stage crew, and at the right moment, the butler would come along, apply the appropriate force to collapse the table, and it would set in its broken place until the cue came in the music for it to be repaired, and Mary Poppins waves her hand to magically repair the table, and repaired. So the collapsing table that we just saw is battery powered and belt driven. It would need to be set in place by the stage crew before the scene begins, and it's controlled by these limit switches here, so that using this remote control here, which is just a car remote, a door lock remote that you can purchase anywhere, it would be set in place so that the table is now ready to collapse, and any weight that's forced down in the table will force it to collapse, and then it will reset itself by hitting the other limiter switch. Now, of course, it would reset itself if it were collapsed all the way to the ground, and there's enough spring power provided by these bungee cables, as well as this spring here. And again, it's control battery power and remote activated, so it can be activated by the actors on stage or by stage crew off stage using this remote, which has, I believe, at least a 30-foot remote radius, if not more. And then you can see this cable coming off. That's simply a charge cable. When not in use, we like to keep it on a trickle charger so that the battery stays fresh. But that cable can be removed, or it can be rolled up inside and left on, so that each night after performance, stage crew can keep the battery on a charger. Okay, so continuing in the kitchen scene, this is the set of shelves and kitchen items that collapses when Roberts and I, the butler, runs into them. And this is designed to be mounted somewhere on the set, or it can be freestanding as long as it's placed in a place where the sight lines are such that a member of the crew or even a spare cast member can be hidden behind it. And at the right moment, when Roberts and I runs into it, the switch is pulled and the plates and everything are left dangling. And at the right moment, when Mary's magic is cued, everything resets itself.